When I first met Derrick, I just saw, you know, a very average player. He was not a Division I player out of high school. He was not. He didn't have Division I size. He didn't have Division I athleticism. I mean, he was coachable. He's got a high basketball IQ. He's a great teammate. All of those things. But the initial thing was, you know, I had an average, you know, middle school player that wanted to get better. That dunk at that moment, I jumped up.
It's like, who was that?
I don't know where that came from. You listen, and he's not athletic, he's not, you know, he's not aggressive, and in one play, he was athletic and aggressive.
Even after it happened, it kind of surprised me. It came a long way from being here, barely able to dunk my entire high school career to that. It's a small town, so like kind of everybody kind of knows everybody, so there's not any distractions, really not much to do. When I was younger, my mom would drop me off at the rec center before work, and we'd just be in there playing basketball all day. If you're just in the gym all the time, I think it helped me get to where I'm at.
I just tried to encourage him to do what he enjoyed. We never had to like force him to go to practice or, hey, go shoot the basketball or something. He's always, you know, doing that on his own. And yeah, his dad did play a big part because he was happy to go with him at any time to go do that too, so.
He beat me one time, which he loves telling the story, like my senior year. So we were playing like to 11, and he had 10 for like the longest time, because then I really started trying. He catches like on the wing and he just throws it up, banks it in for game. It's the last time he beat me.
When I first met Derrick, he didn't want to come back after the first workout. The workout was too hard. Now the thing that I noticed about him was he was very coachable. I noticed that you could teach him certain moves and he would stare. And he would look specifically at your feet and at your shoulders.
Yeah, it's my freshman year. I was a little guy. I don't think I was very healthy, I feel. My arms are super skinny, but my feet are big if you had my shoes in here compared to the rest of my body.
I knew it was important to him to, at the end of high school, to continue to play somewhere. Some people look and say, oh, it's gotta be D1, gotta be one. This gotta be a place where he can play. You know, not just wear a jersey or a uniform.
I mean, I didn't have really anybody talking to me. I never talked to a D1, so I assumed it would never be that. I mean, there were just times where I didn't even know if I was gonna play anymore. So I just kind of just kept playing, and Coach Culver got the job at UCCS and brought me along, and I just thought it was a good fit because I could go there. My parents would come watch me play, and yeah, there was times where I was just like, maybe I'll just go to school and just be a regular student.
You know, he could handle it a little bit, could shoot it a little bit. Wasn't doing anything very well, anything great, but you could tell he knew the game. He moved well without the ball in his hands. Defensively, he was in good position. And you could tell his body was still growing. You know, he's young. And so he's very intriguing, you know, to see what his upside was.
Alley-oop!
Brings everybody to their feet, the student section.
Yeah.
Not as loud as they have been all night long.
I thought it was good for him to take a chance that, you know, even if it didn't work out, it was much better to take that leap. I think in life we are so often just happy with where we're at, and, you know, we always wonder the what ifs, so why not do it and take that leap? And if you fail, at least you know you tried.
And with the 29th pick in the 2017 NBA Draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Derrick White from the University of Colorado.
Yeah, I mean, when I found out I was gonna get drafted to San Antonio, I was just so thankful, because, I mean, all you hear about is the Spurs way, and how they play the right way, and I felt like that is perfect for me, and just gave me a chance to keep improving and learn from probably the greatest coach of all time and one of the greatest organizations in the league. So I was just super thankful to be part of the Spurs organization.
Getting drafted by the Spurs was a blessing for Derrick. I think when we were all at the draft party, sort of waiting and getting a little anxious towards the end of the first round, and you know when the call came in, there was just a, you know, not only the celebration for what his path has been and for him making it to be a first round draft pick, but also the fit. I think everyone in the room collectively knew that this, you know, Spurs is a special organization.
You know, when he first got here, I was just trying to find him. He'd be in the same room with me and I wouldn't know he's there. I know that sounds crazy, but it's true. He is so quiet, so humble, in a way unconfident, and obviously he didn't start at the highest levels of basketball. So he just took on that sort of a feeling about himself. And then he progressed pretty quickly, doing well in the D-League and then coming up to the Spurs, and you know the rest.
You know, he truly is a San Antonio Spur. We don't have conversations about, I'm in the NBA. You know, the conversation is, man, he wants to be great for the Spurs. He wants to be a great teammate. He wants to be a winner. He wants to carry the torch. And so he sees something completely different than I'm drafted and I'm here. He sees the responsibility of the overall organization.
How are we doing up here?
Good.
We good?
Uh-huh.
We have a good week?
Mm-hmm.
We can get some wins?
The most remarkable thing to me is that every time Derrick's on a stage, he's able to elevate his game. As a person, he's able to elevate it. He's able to handle the temperament of the situation. Going from middle school to, you know, having to play varsity at a new school, but then going from high school, you know, to Division II, and then from Division II to the Pac-12. And then from the Pac-12 to the G League Championship, and then from the G League Championship to the playoffs. I mean, I don't know how many players, you know, that started at such a low level, but continued to have the growth that he's had. So, and it speaks volumes for him as a person.
I'm proud that I kind of haven't changed. I would try to say this, I'm the same kid that I was when I was here at Legend. I mean, I was surrounded by great people that pushed me and just helped me out every step of the way.
He'll always keep his humility because he's just a wonderful young man. He cares about people, he cares about the community, and he's become someone who's just beginning to realize, I've got some skills here, and I've got size to go with it at my position, and I'm just gonna keep playing. So his future is very bright.